This is my ultimate enduring legacy build. This weapon can be used in any content in the game. This weapon is an okay weapon when it comes to invasion missions and infiltration operations, but this is nowhere close to the Thunder Cage in terms of AoE mob clearing. This weapon excels at single target with high HP like boss fights and void intercept battles. Let's start with the weaponry adjustment options. I recommend getting firearm critical hit damage, fire attack, firearm attack, and bonus firearm attack versus Colossus. The main reason why I did not get firearm critical hit rate is because it is only 13 to 14%. The base critical hit rate of this weapon is 20%. Let's assume that you get 13%. 13% of 20% is only 2.6%, which is really not that significant increase, and that is why I chose fire attack. This weapon has a unique ability called quenching. You only need to burn the target and get the 11% firearm attack increase, and that's it. Do not focus on increasing the fire damage on this weapon, as its only purpose is to proc the firearm attack of 11%. For the damage modules, I used action and reaction and rifling reinforcement, increasing firearm attack by 78%. For the critical hit rate modules, I used edging shot and better insight, increasing the firearm critical hit rate by 82%. The base critical hit rate of this weapon is 20%, adding the two modules increases it from 20% to 36.4%. For the firearm critical hit damage, I use concentration priority and better concentration, increasing the firearm critical hit damage by 194.8%. The base critical hit damage of Enduring Legacy is 2.3 times. The weapon option increases it by 40% and the two modules by 194.8%, totaling to 7.7 times critical hit damage. For some reason, the weapon readjustment option critical hit damage is not added to the total critical hit damage, and that is why it only shows 6.78 times. I also added expand weapon charge, which increases the rounds per magazine by 49%. Adding this module increases the base rounds per magazine from 115 to 171 bullets. I also added weak point sight, which increases the weak point damage by 35%. The base weak point damage of this weapon is 1 times. Adding the module increases it from 1 times to 1.35 times, which is really not that big of an increase on paper, but this is one of the best modules when it comes to increasing the damage output of the weapon. Last but not the least, I added two fire rate modules. Fire rate up increases fire rate by 25%, and a special module, sharp precision shot. This special module increases fire rate by 40% at 10 stacks. It also reduces recoil by 50% at 10 stacks, and this module also increases firearm attack by 60% at 10 stacks. Let's talk about how to reload animation cancel. This is actually very easy to do, but it requires a little bit of practice and getting used to it. To start, every time you reload a weapon, all you have to do is press your sub attack, roll, or grappling hook to cancel the animation at around 60% of the bar. The moment you see the magazine inserted into the weapon, you can then press your sub attack, roll, or grappling hook. The latency does matter, that is why this trick needs a little bit of practice and getting used to it. You can also use the reload animation on any type of weapon, from SMG to sniper rifles. But as I've said, it requires a little bit of practice. Also, do not screw up the reload animation, or else you are going to end up wasting more time reloading the weapon. This weapon also eats up a lot of bullets, especially with the module sharp precision shot. This weapon will eat up your ammo reserve pretty fast, so to increase the ammo reserve, all you have to do is equip any general rounds weapon like SMG, assault rifle, machine gun, and handgun. In my case, I'm using the last dagger and added the following modules. General rounds compulsive and max general rounds increases the ammo reserve by 110%. So every time you see a General Rounds ammo on the ground, all you have to do is swap to the weapon that you have installed these two modules, and it will increase the total ammo reserve. I also added better weapon weight and a special module also called special weapon weight. These two modules will increase the swap animation speed, and every time you swap, you get a defense increase of 111% for 5 seconds. Overall, this weapon is pretty good, but I prefer using this weapon for single target bosses and in void intercept battle. Also, this weapon only needs 9 crystallization catalysts, which is pretty affordable nowadays. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.